Hey everyone, Melcadrien here. We're back with more Our Darker Purpose. Finally, the achievements are useful for something. I mean, yes, there are other games that use achievements for something, but this particular one gives us the achievements to allow us to have access to our classes, which is an interesting thing that's different from the memory rooms of the past. In my opinion, anyways. And I honestly think that's an interesting thing to have, because, well, now we don't have to try and grind for all these memory rooms just so we can get all our classes. We just complete the achievements, complete the tasks that are set ahead of us. Reminds me of that game. On the basement task. Maybe it's called, and no, the one where you have to find the carrots and the rabbits and stuff. Oh, you mean? Don't say it. We could get sued. Really? I mean, I don't know. I should have paid more attention in law school. Law school? You're weird. Now the first one we already know, which is basically. Well, basically, this game is similar to Binding of Isaac, yes. The carrots and whatnot? I have no idea what they're talking about on that one. I've not seen that game. Maybe it's talking of a different indie game? Maybe not. I'm not too sure. But just saying the name in the game wouldn't exactly be a whole lot of cause for concern. Would it? And I just clipped on the desk. Zen and the Art of Pummeling in a Clockwork Orphanage. Let's go with Zen. Here's hoping we get that fedora. Because, as you well know, that fedora is basically our key to surviving the upper floors. I wish we had some sort of class like that, but so far, we don't know about any. Come on. There we go. Escher's compass. No, ricochet shots is not that bad. Hey. Gloams and their hitboxes. Alright, what do we have for the boss? Maybe it's Frothy and we can get that achievement. Nope, we've already gotten the achievement from the markings though, so I'm gonna save my chalk. Game? It's been doing that recently. I don't know what's going on with that. Maybe they'll find out when they optimize the game. Considering this game isn't fully released. I mean, I believe it's still in the early access phase. And it's still not on Steam yet, from what I've checked. But then, right now it's this Christmas sale, so the game won't appear on the front page right this instant. But yeah, maybe in the future the game will get some optimizations. Like, every game needs optimizations. Do not ignore optimizing your game, because optimizing your game is crucial to making people be able to play the game, to like the game. If you don't optimize it for, you know, people to play the game, you're basically saying we're not doing our complete and total job. Wealthy. I mean, here's an example. Assassin's Creed. I mean, more accurately, the Revelations. Now, that game is really graphic intensive, but, and here's the big but, not the but you're thinking of, but the but meaning that, well, I'm able to play that just fine. Same with Borderlands. The thing about it is that the game is well optimized for it. It could be the engine, it could be the graphics, or it could be both and they've been optimized correctly. If you get it optimized, the game will play better. The game will be better. Now, that doesn't mean that optimizing it will be able to fix all the problems, yes. Such as Binding of Isaac, since it's made in Flash. Now, I'm not saying that Binding of Isaac is a bad game. I'm saying that seeing as it's made using Flash, there are just so much limitations that you can only do with that engine. You can't do a whole lot of it. Once you've gotten the game as it is, and you try to optimize it, there is only so much you can optimize with it. And the more content you add to it, the harder it becomes to optimize it. Flash games have that tendency. Unless you make it simple and web-based. But we're not talking simple or web-based here, we're talking complex stuff. Binding of Isaac is not easy. I mean, look at all the items, look at all the content. It's similar to Our Darker Purpose, yes. But in terms of styles, yes, they're different. Our Darker Purpose is made using a different engine, though. I don't exactly know what engine it's using, though. Maybe it's their own in-home engine with some other ones. Maybe I can find out on the credits. We'll check that out later, though. But the fact is, there's only so much that you can do with Binding of Isaac. With Rebirth, yeah, I've seen a gif of it, and I can see that, yeah, they've made some great progress. And the results are very, very interesting. Can't wait to play the game, though. It didn't get destroyed. Maybe it's because it was in midair. Yeah, I would like to play the Rebirth version because, well, it's made using the design language of it's made using a developing language instead of a animation language. Flash is basically for animation stuff, not for gameplay and graphics. There's only so much you can do with that stuff. Well, we've already defeated you, so I'm not gonna worry about getting up close and personal with you. That's an interesting glitch. It made two lights. Alright, next floor, cafeteria, and well stocked. Hmm. And we have a memory room. So we should be able to find some information about something. Don't know what, but we'll find out soon enough. Okay, the memory room's not up there. What about down here? Nope. Take that. Escher's compass succeeding for us. Though collision is still a bit it needs work. Let's see. You know what, let's go with the unbearable interest of being. I mean, there's a problem with the collision. Strange. I was able to walk past that, and yet... yeah. There's some strange collision with that. That needs to be looked at. It's over there. We get some chalk. Gotta wait for the fire to go out. Yes! More chalk. Now if we had Monty Chalk, oh, that would make things much better. Alright, south of the door. But yeah, I can't wait for the Binding of Isaac Rebirth game. It seems like there's a lot of overhaul, making it much, much more playable for those who, well, don't have computers that work well with it. The Capulets. Although every student feared Goneril's physical strength, they also knew that Reagan was even more powerful. Her followers, the Capulets, are pretty, well-dressed, and universally envied. It was they who convinced Kevin the Timid to try to climb the weather vane that extended off the high northern terrace, that drove little Robert to squeeze himself down through the heating ducts into the cellars. Well, this proves that there is the existence of lower floors. This may be interesting. You know, an interesting concept for lower floors. And how it's gonna work out. Maybe it'll work out as DLC, or maybe it'll be implemented further in the game. Who knows? In the aftermath of the disappearance, the Capulets have moved to the upper floors and graduated to something darker than simple manipulation. Many students worry about the strange markings that Capulets leave on the walls, or how they seem to be able to summon flames and ice on command, or the possibility that they've allowed still more malevolent forces than themselves to enter the school. That's foreboding. Yeah, that is also one other unexplained thing. How did they, you know, how were they able to, you know, summon up fire and ice? Now, Cordy may also have that similar effect, because she can summon up fire. I mean, I'm calling it the Burning Voice regardless. It may not be fire, but it could also be fire. 18 kills in a row without using juice awards 20% dodge. That's a lot, but I still have no use for that. Shrinking a nightmare. No, I don't want to swap out Schooner with my manuscript. But I still think that there's still a possibility for another character. Someone who somehow miraculously survived getting wiped out, getting destroyed. Now, who this character is? It could be anyone's guess, sans the developers, because they can figure it out. I mean, they could be a child, they could be a teenager, they could be an adult for all we know. It's interesting if that were there, at least in my eyes anyways. Maybe it could be a different alternate timeline or something that happens that sent Courtney falling down, or maybe, just maybe, that in order for Courtney to escape, and I'm just assuming here because we never actually beaten the game yet, that Courtney has to go downwards in order to escape Edgewood. Ahri's binoculars and badly etched arrow. Let's hold on to the tokens for now. I'm not sure I want to get the arrow because, well, even though the arrow would be a nice thing, I just don't see myself using the chalk unless I have Monte Choco, which I don't have. Frozen Few. What's the Frozen Few have? Let's see. Defeat the Frozen Few without failing a maze once. That's easy. I mean, that is very easy. I mean, here's the thing, the mazes mostly are to the left. Not to the right, but to the left. And the mazes are easy to complete, considering it's a small room and you can really see the layouts with how bright the room is. I didn't even need to go through the maze. My fire shot managed to get them before the maze was even made. Well, after the maze was made. Oh, that is beautiful, my friends. I wonder if I can do that again. Okay, now this is a much more sinister one. Devious. And my health is down. Good thing I still have the teddy bear to keep me alive. For now, anyways. I didn't fail the maze, guys. What's going on here? What's going on here, guys? I should have gotten the achievement for that. I should have gotten the achievement. Maybe it's not implemented yet. Ah. with the Grammy gotchas, and I'm not messing with that. I am seriously not messing with that. Yes, I took a lot of damage. I wish I never had fought that guy in that room. But what happened, happened. And I really didn't like how that happened. Hey. But the game is not that simple. If something's bound to get you, it will. Murphy's Law 101. Well, at least I'm getting my juices back. Tokens too. Oh boy. Well, we found the fortress already. Doesn't mean we're going in yet. Still need to level up. I'm hoping we get some more skills, because what we have right now isn't exactly a whole lot. And here I was hoping to get that skill from the Frozen Few, but for some odd reason, that achievement is not working. Developers, if you're watching this, you may want to take a look at that achievement. Alright. Ah, the broken clock theory. Which is still an interesting theory among all the other temporal theories. And I still would assume that time is still progressing, even though Edgewater's is resetting. Unless Edgewood is a temporal anomaly in and of itself. Right off the bat, it starts attacking us. Juice Box of Darkness and Kite Runner Kites. Juice Box of Darkness. Probably should have run under the bed. Anyways, dodge chalk clouds, dodge this. The rooting clothes. What are those called, anyways? Maybe it's dirty laundry. That's what we'll call it, dirty laundry. Dirty and filthy and crusty that it sticks to people temporarily before it, well, disintegrates. Man, I'm not being nice with my teddy bear. Ice tray? Let's get the draught. Let's get the tray, the fear. May as well get them for the collection, since I am gonna 100% this. Complete every achievement, get every item. It's pretty much gonna be similar to Northern Lion's Binding of Isaac's Platinum God. Getting everything 100%, even post-content. And even then, I'm still gonna play the game because, hey, this game is fun. And I would like people to play this game because it's fun. Now, my words may not convince all of you, but I say that this game is very fun. It's like Binding of Isaac. It's fun. And apparently they modified the ice tray because it's only firing three ways instead of every way. Which makes it less... It makes it more useless, actually. I mean, it's no longer versatile. It's not exactly versatile anymore. I mean, it was versatile back then, but now it's no longer versatile. It's more like a hindrance. I mean, yes, it may have some convenience at some times, but the effectiveness has been severely reduced. These guys spawning faster than expected. You know, if they destroy collectibles, why don't they end up destroying the fortress? It's an interesting point. I mean, it is a collidable of some sort, which would make it destructible in some cases. And yet, the kid ran straight through it like it was nothing. Sheesh, these kids are coming out of the woodwork. Well, I kind of expected that things were going to go south. But... anyways, that's it for this run. Seriously, that's a bug right there, like the back of my hand. I completed it without failing it, so what's the problem there? Oh well. You know, the more we tip the counselor, the more we get some more benefits. Additional juice box, extra class. I'm thinking that donating some more credits would be effective in that. And here I was hoping we would be fighting Frothy. Oh well. Anyways, as usual, link to the game is in the description. I will have a link to the Steam page when it's available. As usual, this is Melcadrien. This is the playthrough of Our Darker Purpose. I'll see you guys next time. Have a great day, and happy gaming.